about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now let's head down to the coin toss, brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything.
And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down to the 33-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Right. He's got the corner. Nice gain as he works to the right side. From their own 38-yard line. Second down. Makes it out to about the 50. So he keeps it and he gets a big first down.
Quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
Makes the catch and look out. Steps out of bounds at the 47.
That'll make it second and seven.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
The defender snuck right through the blocks and just drilled the ball carrier. That's a standout play.
Runs it, and he stopped short of the line of scrimmage. And watch out, they're going to bring the heat right here. The Bulldogs have got a guy at quarterback that is a true leader. We found that out this week talking to him.
We sure did, Brad. It was interesting this week as you and I prepared for this game, finding out that he called a players-only meeting without any of the coaches just to get this team focused and let them understand what it takes to go on the road and to win this kind of game. And when you have that kind of leadership, you got a real chance to be able to go on the road and win.
Second and eight. Ball on their own 28. He's taken down at the 36.
Number 98 makes the tackle at the 36-yard line.
The stop at the 38.
They played it pretty carefully, going with the run in a short yard situation, and it paid off.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 38. They hand it off. Runs outside for a nice gain.
Brings him down. Gain of 7. That'll bring up second and 3.
Down, right around the 42-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give them a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good game.
From the 42-yard line, first down. Looking for the corner, and he carries the ball for a nice game.
That makes it second and 6.
Come on.
29-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 29. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Gives it to the back. Inside the 10. And he's taken down at the 7-yard line. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Forward to about the 7. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. And he throws it away. The defense has really held their own the last two plays. Now it's third and goal from the 7. Looks middle, got his back, and he's tackled at the 10-yard line. Georgia is looking to go up by 3. Kicks up, and he's got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24-yard line.
Georgia's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for them so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play.
Fine, big hit there to stop it. We've played one. Georgia in front, 3-0.
That brings up second and 9.
Set to resume action here in the second quarter. We've got a tight ball game. And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the 5-wide set. Complete. He's got room. It's on the ground. And there isn't anyone who's going to catch this cornerback. Touchdown, Bulldogs.
Defensive touchdowns give teams such a big morale lift. This is a really nice play to grab the loose ball and take it the distance.
He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fakes the handoff, and he's in trouble. That's a great tackle at the 29.
from their own 29-yard line. Third down. And he tackles him hard at the 20-yard line. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Tackle made at the 40-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. And down he goes at the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line, second down. Quick throw. He's knocked out of bounds around the 47-yard line. At the 36-yard line. From the 36-yard line. First down. Tackle made around the 26-yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. He's tackled around the 19-yard line.
That'll make it second to seven.
From the 19-yard line, it's second down. Here comes the pressure. And he just gets rid of it. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
The Bulldogs saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action.
Quick strike to the receiver. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice game.
When they broke the huddle, I'm sure everybody knew the ball was going to go to this receiver, and he still brought it in to give this team a big lift.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown, Georgia! Splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 24.
No matter how much people want to talk about points and offense, I still think that the best offense is a great defense. When you put a zero up there, it makes it pretty easy on your own offense to go out there and win the game.
It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. him hard at the 41-yard line. Nice play there to pick up the first down.
He did a great job of getting up in the air, ignoring the defenders, and coming down with the ball.
First and 10. Ball on their own 41. Quick throw to the tight end.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Slings it out and it gets tipped.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort.
So it's third down and they've got about 2 yards to go. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Five wide. Quick strike and he drops it. Second and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. Complete. He's down. Idaho will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. He's taken down at the 31. Pulls it in and he's in the open field. And they make the stop at the 22.
That brings in second and one.
Here's the halfback for the first down grab. This is the 11th play of this drive. It's caught first down, and he's out of bounds.
Boy, when you can rely on your tight end to move the chains, you've got a big-time advantage over any defense.
First and goal from the 5 and looking to cap this off with a touchdown. Nice run up the middle. He gets sacked on the play.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
We've got third and goal. Ball on the 6. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. 17-3, Bulldogs.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Well, as an iconic figure once said, that escalated quickly. Got away a little bit from this team that's supposed to be in control of the game, and now suddenly they aren't. And, David, we say this every week. We say this team has to go into the locker room, make some adjustments. They have to change things, have to give a big speech. What's the most important, the most impactful thing that this team could do in the second half to turn this game around?
Well, I think you come in the half and you do have all those great speeches, and the coaches do try to get you fired up. But then you realize that you just got to execute. And I think you don't come in as a favorite, as a more talented team, and panic. And that's something that you can't do. So I think the second half, you come out and you try to get some positive things going. You try to get some first downs. Stop thinking about getting the 14 points back right away. Start putting drives together. Then you get points. Then you're down, you know, 7 points, or you're down one score. You get it more manageable. But listen, when you're the more talented team, you don't have to panic. And I think the coaches tell you, listen, nothing's changed. The schedule's going to stay the same. We just got to make more plays, less mistakes in the second half.
Just about ready to start the second half. We're going to watch all the games around the country, including some coaches who like to sample the surface that they're playing on. I'll keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I'm going to go to the cafeteria. You want some turf, some AstroTurf or anything?
Yeah, if they've got some, I'll chew on that in the second half. Here's the second half for you to chew on with Brad and Kirk.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
So we're just about ready to return to action.
They bring him down in the backfield. They couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage on that one.
I don't think they did a very good job of selling the pass. The defense was able to read the play and come right in there and make a nice stop.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. On the ground, up the middle. Gets to about the 24-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. Third down.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got. Mike 41.
Man, that's tough for this defense. They came so close to stopping the conversion, but they'll have to stay out there again now.
From their own 36-yard line, it's first down. Draw play. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
Gain of 2 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 46. Nice run, and he's brought down. Zips it to the tight end. He gets hit out of bounds at the 31-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 31. Tries to buy some time. Slides down. Good gain there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
It's the 9th play of the drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage. From the 19-yard line, first down. The 10. Touchdown, Bulldogs. And he converts the extra point. Georgia to kick.
take it from the two. He's to the 20. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll bring him down right around the 22-yard line. The defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. Here they go on the draw, and they'll lose yards. So the defense does their job well on that series.
And now they should come away with pretty good field position. So consider that a big stop.
He's taken down at the 45. We see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 45. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Good open field tackle. He'll get the call again, and they push him out at the 39.
Good for a gain of 6 yards.
From the 39-yard line, it's second down.
When you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Passes it to the middle of the field, and he's tackled at about the 39-yard line. So they're going to go for it here. First down, and down he goes at the 30-yard line. They'll work the left side. Gets to about the 27-yard line. One more quarter to play, and this one appears to be well under control. 24-3, Bulldogs. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. He steps up. And he's going to be sacked.
A great defensive end in college football just pins his ears back and has, again, that extra instinct to know when to jump the snap count, when to take a chance on third down. And it seems like they almost save their extra pass rush and extra incentive as far as their energy when it really matters on a third down, when they feel like they can beat that offensive tackle and get off the line of scrimmage a little bit quicker. And that's something that I think we've seen him do throughout this game.
They go with a screen here, and the halfback's got it. Knocked out of bounds around the 18-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
This is the 10th play of this drive. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That makes it second and six.
From the 14-yard line, second down. Corner. They get in. Touchdown.
Outstanding run and great execution by the entire offensive unit, especially the blocking up front.
So the booth is trying to determine exactly where they'll spot the ball. So they're going to try and determine exactly where the ball was when he went down.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after the review, they reverse the call on the field. First down. So inside the five with a first and goal. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Touchdown.
Kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Georgia's just not going to let him come for air, I guess.
This defense has just been stifling. They've shut down the running game. They've, for the most part, limited the big plays in the pass game. They've got a nice lead here in the fourth quarter.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries. Up for the sack.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out of practice, they told us there were some big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against it, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, better get back to that drawing board, because these defensive ends are just too quick.
Zips it to the back. Tackle made at the 30. From their own 30-yard line, it's third down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle at the 49-yard line. Their own 49-yard line. It's first down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Complete. He's got room. He's knocked out of bounds at the 34. It to the 32-yard line.
That's a gain of two. That makes it second and eight.
Second and eight coming up here. Ball on the 32-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
You know, penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 17-yard line.
Football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
Davis and David Pollock here. David, a first half filled with highlight plays from both teams.
Oh, absolutely. As a player, Reese, you wanted to make ESPN SportsCenter top 10 plays.
You did, I know.
You try to accomplish that. A lot of guys going out there doing that right now. There's a second half to play, but you got to feel good, especially when you're making those explosive plays and you got a chance to hear da-da-da, da-da-da.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Taken down at the 32. Just over a minute left. That's the end of the ball game, and our final score in this one, 31-10, Georgia. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.